Hello students, in this video lecture we are going to perform the chemistry practical for class 9. This is the third practical in the CBSE syllabus. The aim of the practical is to carry out the following reactions and classify them as physical or chemical changes. First, reaction of iron nail with copper sulfate solution. Second, burning of magnesium in air. Third, reaction of zinc with dilute sulfuric acid. Fourth, heating of copper sulfate. And fifth, reaction of sodium sulfate with barium chloride. So let's begin with our first experiment. Reaction of iron nail with copper sulfate. Materials required. For this, we require copper sulfate, two iron nails, thread, sandpaper, glass rod, distilled water, spatula, a clean beaker, test tubes, test tube stand, and two clamp stands. Procedure. Take sufficient quantity of distilled water in a clean beaker. To this, add a required quantity of copper sulfate. Stir the contents in the beaker using a glass rod until the copper sulfate crystals in the beaker dissolve completely. Pour some copper sulfate into a test tube. Clamp the test tube to a stand. Then pour some copper sulfate into another test tube and clamp this to the other stand. Take two iron nails. Clean these by rubbing them with a sandpaper so that their color appears grayish. Tie one nail with a thread and immerse it into one of the test tubes containing copper sulfate solution. Keep the test tube undisturbed for about 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, the color of copper sulfate solution containing the iron nail turn light greenish in color, whereas the color of the solution in the other test tube does not change. The greenish color of the solution is due to the presence of iron ions. Remove the iron nail from the solution. Compare it with the other nail. There is a brown coating of copper on the nail that was dipped in the copper sulfate solution. The other nail retains the grayish color. The second experiment is burning of magnesium in air. Materials required. We will require a small piece of magnesium ribbon, sandpaper, tongs, china dish, red litmus paper, and Bunsen burner. Procedure. Take the magnesium ribbon and rub it with a sandpaper so that it looks silvery white. Now hold the magnesium ribbon with a pair of tongs. Light the magnesium ribbon. It burns brightly and a white ash is left behind. Collect the ash of the burnt ribbon in a china dish and label it as magnesium oxide. Magnesium burns in air to form magnesium oxide. Take a little amount of magnesium oxide using a spatula. Place this on a moist red litmus paper. Result: the red litmus paper turns blue, indicating magnesium oxide is basic in nature. The third experiment is reaction of zinc with dilute sulfuric acid. Materials required. For this, we will require zinc granules, dilute sulfuric acid, sodium hydroxide, test tubes, test tube stand, sodium sulfide flakes, gas discharge bent tube, and candle. Procedure. In a clean test tube, pour some dilute sulfuric acid. Using a spatula, add some zinc granules into the sulfuric acid. A brisk reaction occurs and gas bubbles evolve. This hydrogen gas is produced because hydrogen is displaced by zinc, as zinc is more reactive than hydrogen. This is a displacement reaction. Now bring a burning candle near the mouth of the test tube. On bringing the flame near the mouth, the hydrogen gas burns instantaneously with a pop sound. The fourth experiment is heating of copper sulfate. Materials required. For this, we require hydrated copper sulfate crystals, distilled water, spatula, boiling tubes, test tube stand, test tube holder and Bunsen burner. Procedure. Hold the boiling tube with a test tube holder. Using a spatula, take a small quantity of copper sulfate crystals from the watch glass and put it into the boiling tube. Heat the boiling tube over the flame of the burner, first gently and then strongly. On heating, copper sulfate crystals change its color from blue to white. Hydrated copper sulfate contains water of crystallization. On heating, CuSO4 crystals lose its water molecules and form white colored anhydrous copper sulfate. Remove the boiling tube from the flame and cool it for some time. Using a dropper, take a small quantity of distilled water. Add 2 to 3 drops into the boiling tube containing the sample anhydrous copper sulfate obtained after heating. The white copper sulfate turns blue, indicating that the blue-colored hydrated copper sulfate is regenerated. So this reaction is a reversible chemical change. Our fifth experiment is the reaction of sodium sulfate with barium chloride. Materials required. For this, we require barium chloride, sodium sulfate solution, dilute HCl, test tube and test tube rack. Procedure. Take a small quantity of barium chloride in a test tube. To this, add a small quantity of sodium sulfate solution. On mixing the solutions of sodium sulfate and barium chloride, a white precipitate of barium sulfate is formed, which is insoluble in water. Let the precipitate settle down by leaving the test tube for around 15 minutes. After some time, the precipitate of barium sulfate settles down. Barium and sulfate ions react together to form barium sulfate, and the other product, that is sodium chloride, remains in the solution. Such reactions in which there is an exchange of ions between the reactants are called double displacement reactions.